ever medal all-around world final for Great Britain. Well done, Jessica Gadarova, on Making History.
Literally, I don't know what to say. I'm just over the moon.
Welcome back to the fourth day of the World Gymnastics Championships alongside triple world champions Beth Tweddle and Max Whitlock. Now, we've seen 3 days of competition, 3 medals, 2 Olympic qualifications, and yesterday that historic all-around bronze medal from Jessica Gadarova and a fourth place finish for Alice Kinsella. Beth, did you ever predict that? I mean, there's been some rise, hasn't there, on the women's side in British gymnastics over the past year?
The strength and the depth within the British team on the women's side at the minute is incredible. I mean, we've seen them producing results and medals on the European stage, and we've been gradually getting closer and closer on the world stage. But last night, they had to hold their nerve. All top 6 gymnasts did the routines the best they could have done. Yeah. And so for the fact that they were able to produce under that pressure, Jessica and Alice, and have top 2 gymnasts in the top 4 was insane.
Max, the difficulty level was incredible. The execution was unbelievable. And to actually be able to deliver under the pressure as we got to that final round says an enormous amount.
A massive amount. Like, being able to deal with that, you can have the most talented gymnast in the world, but if you can't compete, that's when you're going to see it all collapse on the competition day. So these gymnasts, you're seeing them every time going out there just really striving to compete, do their best and really pulling through and grabbing opportunities wherever they can. Yeah. And yesterday was an incredible show for that. To go around last piece where the pressure's the highest, perform like that was crazy.
And so far at these World Championships, the women are competing better than the men. Yeah. And it's been a while, hasn't it, within the British camp since that's happened?
Yeah, I think there's a lot to do here. I think you will see transitions like that naturally, but they're overall a young team, nothing to lose type mentality team, which is very powerful when it goes into competition. Yeah. When you used to think about off the back of a Tokyo, the confidence build after that would be absolutely crazy, which is going to help them here. And it's going to do exactly the same. You know, what we've done from here is just another springboard of confidence. Really.
Yeah, well, we're moving on to the men's all-around competition this evening, and Max, this is something that you know all about, a medalist yourself, which we'll get onto in a second. But the very first all-around world medal that we got was back in 2009 with a teammate of yours, yeah, Dan Keatings, and there he is as a trailblazer. Fantastic high bar routine to land on that world all-around silver, and what a character he was.
He's amazing, like, just genuinely such an amazing guy, a mega, mega talent, and kind of an inspiration for so many of us younger gymnasts that were coming through. Like, having the privilege to be training alongside Dan as a real kind of mega talent on pommel, for me, was really, really helpful. Massively, massively, massively influential in that.
Well, talking of him being an inspiration, fast forward 5 years to Nanning in China, and here you are, taking a silver yourself in the men's all-around. What are your memories of those 6 pieces of apparatus and that competition? Were you aiming for a medal?
I think it was a four-year cycle for me. So after that, it was like aiming for Rio to be able to kind of prove myself as an all-around gymnast. That was a real kind of target for me. So it wasn't thinking about, you know, standing on that podium there or getting a medal. It was thinking about what score could I score, which could hopefully compare to the rest of the world. But don't get me wrong, standing on that podium with my idol, Kohei Uchimura, was an amazing experience.
Well, out come the gymnasts then. These are the top all-around qualifiers from just the other day, the top 24 gymnasts competing here. Lucas Dowser, the last of the gymnasts to be competing on rings. And then we're going to move to pommel horse. And stand by, because first out and first up on pommels is Jake Jarman, Max.
Yep.
Now, obviously, traditionally, for Great Britain, pommel horse is a good start. Would this be good for Jake to be starting there?
I think so. I think if he gets a steady routine in, it'll be great for him. I think Jake's in a great position in terms of mindset. He needs to go in here. He's got that team medal bag. It's all like almost that nothing to lose mindset. Go all out, and give it your best shot.
For him, what do you think he'll be aiming for? Will it be a top 10 finish, or will he have that sort of number 10 in his sights?
He definitely has that potential. He should be in the top 10. That's what he's 100% capable of. If he can kind of push in and make it kind of hard for that top 5, those competitors, he'll be more than pleased. But I think a top 10 finish is massively respectable. But he's capable. You know, he's got the real standout pieces, yeah, which actually can make him bump up really, really quickly. So the floor and vault, when he gets around to them, he could jump up those standings very quickly.
Be interested, Beth, to see what vault he goes for tonight to try and keep that consistency, because six pieces of apparatus, I mean, it's a long way around, and this is a big, big ask when you think of the work that they've already been doing at these Worlds.
Yeah, it's a huge amount of concentration for a long period of time, and the fact that he's got floor last, like Max was saying, it can really bump him up at the last minute. Yeah. Bolt, we've seen a couple of errors here at these championships, but we've also seen him perform it incredibly. So it'll be interesting to see what he actually does tonight. It's all about himself.
Yeah, yeah. And the top group will be out very, very shortly indeed. Krisztián Balázs of Hungary. So these are the vaulters. You can expect these gymnasts to really sort of fire themselves up these standings right from the very start. Very high scoring piece. And actually, I suppose, Max, it gives you a really good launch pad, quite literally, for the all-around.
I think your first piece is always the most nerve-wracking. It's always the most difficult, no matter what one it is. Your first one, when you go out there, that's where you kind of really feel the pressure. So if you set yourself up right and you can settle in, that goes a very long way.
Now, these are the top qualifiers here. Here comes Joe Fraser. Oh, he's looking calm. He's looking relaxed.
Yep.
And, you know, for this top group, it's been pretty hit or miss as far as these qualifications are concerned. Carlos Yolo of the Philippines, he's certainly in with a shout, but I think it could be a case of who's it going to hit for tonight, and whoever is will be up there on the podium.
I think you're exactly right. I think we've seen that the whole way through this championship. We've seen a lot of mistakes. This team, obviously the top team, will be the main team that we'll see where the kind of the medals are coming from. But you never know. We've seen that so many times. We saw our team of the guys come from eighth to third. You never know how it can plan out, but it is about who goes clean. All these guys are doing massively difficult routines. Who can make it? Who can make it the cleanest on the day? That's what it's all about.
Yeah. I mean, I don't want to stitch anybody up here, but it is possible for Joe Fraser to be up there if it all goes his way. But that is a very, very big ask. And just ahead of these World Championships, Betty Glover caught up with both Joe and Jake to see how their preparations were going.
It's just been quite non-stop since the start of summer. So we've had Commonwealths, Europeans, and then like the shortest break possible, and then straight back into World Champs. You know, it's been quite non-stop. So I've not really had enough time to kind of just like look back on how incredible the summer has been, to be honest.
Are you looking at this as a chance to get your title back?
I guess so. I'm just at the moment focused on every day in training. I'm not thinking about the end result too much right now, but of course it's in the back of my mind.
Are you finding there's a bit of pressure there?
No, I guess like I'm at that point now where I'm just like, I need to enjoy the sport as much as I can. And the pressure is something that comes with that. So it's where you see pressure. Is it nerves or is it pressure? So I'll just take it one step at a time.
World Championships, you know, for a gymnast, it's like the second biggest competition you can go to. So there is increased pressure, you know. But the past two majors that I've been to, you know, I've gone in with the mentality of just enjoying the whole experience.
We're surrounded by an amazing team who have pushed me above and beyond over the summer. It's been a difficult one, but also a successful one, and I truly wouldn't have been able to do it without the guys. We're motivated, we're feeling excited, back on home soil, so yeah, I'm sure the crowd will get behind us.
Zhang Boheng salutes the judges to get this men's all-around final off and running, hoping to retain his all-around title.
Well, no damage done there. Littlest of hops on landing. Super combination of twists there and the straight front somersault. All these moves have a value depending how many twists you do. 2.5 there. That'll be worth a lot. Just a double twist backwards. So all the moves have a value. You add though the highest 10 up. All very nicely done. to get the difficulty score. And then another lot of judges take marks off of 10. That's beautiful extension in that work. Lovely tight legs, toes pointed, good balance in the handstand. So he's been pretty clean so far. Here's the big final tumble. Triple twist, a tiny hop. He did have a little hop on each landing. So those are point ones that the judges will deduct from his 10.
But it felt like a steady, steady start for the current all-around champion. He's in his flow. Great Britain's Jake Jarman takes the pommel horse for his first all-around world final. The first of six pieces then for Jake.
Just got to try and compose himself. Such a difficult piece of apparatus to start, and that's good work. Straight up into the handstand. Gymnast pick up into this double leg circle. Turns and spindles around the handles. That's building the difficulty. He's got this difficult skill between the handles there. Got a push, well done. Keep the legs locked together. Toes pointed. Really extend the body over the pommel horse. He's working well. Come on, come on. This is great work. He just needs fluent up into the handstand. Pirouettes. What a start for Jake Jarman of Great Britain. Fantastic.
It is a super start for Jake. 20 years old, the Commonwealth all-around champion. He's looking good. He's looking calm.
Well, that was a very steady start from Jake. This year he's really come into his own, and he will have gained a lot of experience from competing at Commonwealth and Europeans. What a good start.
Zhang Boheng, 14.033, so he's up on his qualification. It's time for Joe Fraser's all-around competition to begin. He's starting on floor. He is the European all-around champion. What mark can he make here in the world final?
Superstar, not a flicker on that landing. Double twisting, double back. So we've seen double somersault forwards, multiple twisting and double backwards. Oh, he just killed that bounce a little bit, but he got away with it. Just a small step to the side. Very nice. He's really a precise gymnast in those landings. Good extension. These gymnasts have to show flexibility as well as strength. And he is there. Balance and control. Another big tumble. Oh, what a beautiful landing. You saw him kick out of that double front somersault. One more test. Come on, Joe. Make this work. Full twisting, double back, little pace to the side. But that was a great start from Joe.
Well, there were some fantastic landings in there. And a very solid start. Joe's looking good tonight.
Yeah, great start. These gymnasts just need to settle in. There are six pieces to get around. But he'll be very happy with that, Christine. There were some very good landings. Yes, he had a couple of steps here and there, but on the whole, really good.
It's a 13.333 for Jake Jarman. We'll take that. Just down a little on his qualification. Joe's into fourth on the first piece with 13.866. Well, Carlos Yulo of the Philippines qualified first
for the floor final. And he was world champion on this piece back in 2019.
Oh, and that's why, 2.5 twist, immediate punch the floor and double pike front somersault. Double twisting, double straight, you could see the speed and power he put into that huge tumble. Wow, what fabulous twisting there. He changes the pace so dramatically, doesn't he? Suddenly makes that, oh, that is a triple twist just down the side. Now slows it all down, shows great balance, great style. He runs and then the power and speed through that round off is enormous. He's building his difficulty with these multiple twisting passes. Quick look to check the time. Oh, 3.5 to finish. Wow, that lad can land, Matt.
Carlos Yolo surely earning himself a place in the Hall of Fame of the greatest floor workers of all time, because that was something special. Vault it is.
This is impressive. Oh, around in the triple twist. Big vault. It's a little bit out of line. I think he might have stepped out of the landing zone, so pick up a point one. But the Romanians, traditionally very strong on this piece of apparatus.
Well, that'll see him way up the standings to start with, Bertinetti. It's a 14-5, it will. Well, it's a massive 15.166 for Carlos Yolo. So our attentions turn to the Olympic all-around champion. He's qualified seventh for the floor final. Second highest qualifier for the all-around competition. What kind of a competition is Hashimoto going to have?
Well, he's been working on improving the difficulty. Oh, that's a big opening tumble. Triple twisting, double back in the tuck position. Backwards, double twisting, double back. Two very difficult tumbles. Oh, that's nice. Full twist immediately, 2.5. Just watch how many steps this gymnast need to take. That's a point one, but he's not had any so far. This is his non-acrobatic skill, the Russian circle. Just to keep the legs nice and straight, fix the handstand. 2 seconds. Skips into the 2.5, immediately straight front. He's down a little bit on his difficulty to Yolo. Nice triple twist to finish. It'll challenge, but he won't go into first place. Cracking start.
Well, what he's hoping to do is put a few tenths on Bohang. And I think he's done that. Wataru Tanigawa, he was the highest qualifier for this men's all-around final, a 26-year-old. Two Japanese gymnasts in the top eight.
That was a nice start, double twist into the straight front. He's down 0.4 to Hashimoto on difficulty, so he'll have to really nail the landings, and that's how you do it. Double twist in, double back. Was nicely controlled. Two somersaults forward in the pike position. Showing great strength and flexibility. And again with a lifter handstand. 2 seconds minimum. Solid double twist down the side. That was nice, 2.5 into the straight full. Japanese gymnast just float across the floor. So stylish. Renowned for the good landings. Is it a good one to finish? It is. Double back with a full twist.
Oh, and we're already sensing that this all-around competition is going to go right down to the wire. This top group giving very little away. Right, what score are we going to see here for Hashimoto? It's 14.666. That's up on his qualification score. So where's Tanigawa going to be after the first piece of apparatus? Sixth is the answer, 14.266 for him. So this is how things look after the first piece of apparatus. Carlos Yolo of the Philippines leads the field ahead of Hashimoto. And then Bertinetti of Romania, currently in that third place spot. Tanigawa is down in sixth alongside Asher Hong. Joe Fraser in 11th, Jake Jarman at the moment in 15th. Hashimoto in second. Great Britain's Joe Fraser currently in 11th place after the first piece floor. Took a gold at the Commonwealth Games on this piece. Did take a fall in the team final on Pommel Horse. So this, a huge piece of apparatus for Joe Fraser from Great Britain. Piece number 2 of 6.
Oh, nice control, single leg work up into the handstand. And again, now he needs to pick up into the double leg circle. This is very difficult work between the handles. They've almost got to hover above the pommel horse. Come on. Oh, what a shame. He started so, so well. He's just not had a good time on this piece of apparatus since he's arrived in Liverpool.
He really didn't settle in that middle section, did he, Craig?
Oh, you really have to keep your balance over the one handle. Come on, Joe. He can still score well, even with a fall. He has got such a fantastic double leg circle. Look at the extension of the body. This is much better now. Come on. You have to keep pushing down, driving the heels. You see he's got good form in his legs. Straight legs, toes pointed. Come on. Very difficult work. Needs to get up into the handstand, makes the pirouette. What a shame for Joe Fraser. He's really going to have to pick himself up now.
Well, he went all out for difficulty in a bid for a medal. But all is not lost just yet. But it's a long, long way back. Carlos Yolo of the Philippines. And what a buffer he's got with that score of 15.1. Well over a mark ahead of the rest of the field at the moment.
He'll need every 10th. Appears to be his weakest piece of apparatus. He breaks into the flares. The turn there, that's called a spindle. And again. It's a very well-constructed routine to make the best of his ability. Backward travel, that's the Chavado. Come on. Oh! Come on. What a fight up into the handstand, Will! What a fight! Well done, Carlos Yolo.
Absolutely superb to stay on there in the scenario that he found himself in. And he could just well have put himself up on the medal podium with that performance. Joe Fraser, 13.166. ...11.9 for Carlos Yulo. Hashimoto, he's in second at the moment.
Very stylish. The flares and the spindle really whizzing along, clean transition into the double leg and single leg work, smoothly up into the handstand. You can see the height he is above the handle. Great technique and great ability to hold his body straight. He works quickly, he's packing the difficulty in. This work looks so impressive. Now, gotta hold on, gotta make this dismount, he does! He's on his way, I think.
What a pommel routine for Hashimoto. He's got four pieces of apparatus left. A strong piece for him, and he qualified second, but only scored 11.66 in qualification, so he's going to be way up on that.
Yeah, certainly looks a lot different gymnast than we've seen in qualification. Some fabulous work there, the flares, the legs apart. No hesitation on the dismount as well.
Hashimoto up into the top spot, 14.333, and a big smile to match.
Locks out the handstand position. Again, got a nice double leg circle, nice elevation above the apparatus. Pommel horse, it's a bit like riding a bike. The faster you go, the easier it is to balance. So you just slow down the double leg circle, the muscles lose the oxygen and you start to cramp up. And it's working so well. No hesitation there. Well, another fantastic routine for Japan.
Super, he's going to try and get as close as he can to that 14 mark with that pommel horse routine. That will see him well for the rest of the routine and the four that are to come.
Well, he's certainly a master at this apparatus. Just a tiny little bit bent legs as he swung up there. But a very controlled and competent routine, that.
Tanigawa up into third, 13.766. Ilya Kovtun took the bronze world all-round last year. Here he is on vault, Ukraine.
Oh, and beautiful twisting, 2.5 twist. Legs locked together, he'll lose a bit for that big step, but the actual shape in the vault looked legs really glued together. 2.5 twist, just wasn't quite precise with his arm placement on the landing, but that should score well.
14.3 for Kovtun, just 0.1 down on his qualification vault. Well, what can Asha Hong do here on pommel horse? He had a good floor.
Well, it'll be a real internal battle with the Americans to come out on top. He really does whip those flares. He's talking about keeping a fast pace, and he's got that. He's got a lovely extension of the body on the front of the double leg circle. Breaks into the flare. Travelling forward in the Magyar and backwards. Just needs a good handstand, good solid start. This gymnast is having a fantastic competition.
Well, it was a flying pommel horse routine. Wasn't the most difficult that you'll see. It looked impressive. Well, this is the gymnast that's really going to want to push. Hashimoto, Zhang Boheng, current world all-around Thai champion.
Well, he controls those handstands very well indeed. Great style. He's floating above the apparatus. Very difficult work here, great hand placement. All the time, those legs are locked together, chest lifted up at the front. The discipline of this work, that's the very difficult work on the one end, up into that handstand. That routine never looked in doubt, did it? He looked like he can do it every day.
Well, Hashimoto has the highest score of 14.333 on pommel horse today. Now that was packed with difficulty. ...13.7 for Asha Hong. 14.233. It moves him up closer to Hashimoto. Here's how things look after two pieces then. Hashimoto takes the lead. Lorenzo Mincaselli moves up into second, and Zhang Bohang now in the running for a medal. Asha Hong has gone into sixth. Joe Fraser there dropping down to 13th. Carlos Yulo was leading. He's now in 12th, and he is the first up onto rings for the third piece of apparatus here. And it's a good piece for him, this.
I was going to say, he has six difficulty. That's a good position, back up rise into the Maltese. Again, judges looking for the gymnast to be flat with the rings. He is well suited to the power events. Why he struggles a little bit on the pommel horse. Back up rise into the inverted crucifix, a little bit high, but you're only talking a 10th, and he swings so well. Plenty of height there. The front somersault into the crucifix, that's called the Homna. Circles into the crucifix with ease. Oh, he just had to fight a little bit there. He's got to pull it back into the handstand. The concentrate needs a good solid dismount. Wraps in, two somersaults, two twists. Much better than the pommel horse.
He's halfway around and he's on his way back. Carlos Yulo, or Brody Malone, has been having a quietly steady all-round competition so far. He's in 10th, but this could well vault him up the standings here. A big piece for Brody Malone, US all-around champion.
He's such a powerful vaulter. Oh, and that was fantastic! 2.5 twist, he pops off the top. Same vault as Casimir Schmidt, but for me, it was executed just fantastic, Christine.
Yes, really, really well. In fact, it's quite interesting, both on men's and women's side. Execution has played quite a big part in the vault scores. You know, people doing a slightly easier vault, but with a good execution has done well.
Well, Yolo is half a mark down on where he would have wanted to be there. The current leader, Taiki Hashimoto. All-around Olympic champion, 21 years old, and he scored a 14 in qualification.
And although all of these gymnasts are hugely strong, he hasn't really got the physique of a great rings worker. He's quite a slight gymnast. But that's good work. And he certainly can swing. He's absolutely great on high bar. That was very good. Straight into the strength element. You have to have the shoulders in line with the hands. He's got that. Ooh, but just a little bit arched in the back on that swing to handstand. Judges will deduct a little bit for that. So he's made two good handstands. Here comes the dismount. The two twists, the two somersaults. Very good landing. I guess that's probably not his favourite piece, but he performed well.
He does. He's good at swinging on the rings. Just a little bit high on the inverted crucifix, but good routine.
14.5 is very, very helpful in a bid for top five.
9.3 on execution. We said it was better, and it was.
Hashimoto, 13.866 for rings. Wataru Tanigawa, his 26-year-old teammate. Scored exactly the same as Hashimoto in qualification.
Great start there. Each of these strength moves have to be held for 2 seconds. Lovely control. Ooh, just a little soft in the back. The handstand really should try and be as straight as can be. Here's his good swinging element and very nicely finished off with a crucifix. Now comes the swing into handstand. Just a shade off the vertical. Good dismount, but the rings were swinging around a little bit at the end there.
Yeah, it did very, very well with the timing. Get that dismount away. Great Britain's Jake Jarman on vault. He's down on the leaderboard at the moment, but things should well change after this. We're not expecting him to do the 3.5 twist.
Yeah, tactical decision. But expect something equally as impressive. He is a pocket rocket. Watch this. Blocks in the double front with the half turn. Dragulescu. Well, that was stratospheric.
A super vault from Great Britain's Jake Jarman. His third piece is done.
I have to say, this is probably one of my most favourite vaults, this double front with the half turn. I know the twists are very well rewarded and difficult to do, but a real excitement of a 2.5 front somersault with the half turn out. I love to see it done well.
And a 5-6 difficulty, just making it look easy. Huge height. Wataru Tanigawa scores a 13.833. Well, Asher Hong was in sixth. I've been impressed with him so far. Great floor, good pommel horse. This is the all-round title, so he's gonna have to be good on rings.
That looks easy as well. Just 18 years old, he looks a very powerful gymnast already. Very nicely done, shoulders well down. lovely swing and strength. He's very well extended gymnast. You know, legs are naturally locked together. Good technique on the rings. Now that's a lovely solid handstand shape. And again, we should see a good dismount here. He's winding up. Oh, double twist, double straight, little flicker of the knees, but I think he'd be hoping to get a double twisting, double straight.
Well, that was absolutely fantastic stuff from the youngest finalist here in the all-round. A 14-8 for Jake Jarman. It's a huge score. Carlos Yolo scores 13.8 on rings. And yeah, maybe he's nursing a little cough.
Well, his score's gone up, so there's been an inquiry. He was 13.6, gone up 0.2. I did think he had a 6 difficulty from qualification, so obviously changed the score, and every 10th helps.
13.833 for Asha Hong on rings. Zhang Boheng for China. He's hoping to catch Hashimoto, who leads this competition. Boheng in third as it stands.
Well, defending his all-around title. Building his strength work, building his difficulty. Very nice front somersaults to the strength holds and linking the strength holds together. And again, very efficient gymnast on the rings. Quickly to the handstand and again controls the swing very nicely. Double, double, little step back, but that was a very efficient performance, a clean performance.
Well, Hashimoto has the highest ring score of 13.866. It'll be interesting to see where that fits in. Great Britain's Joe Fraser now up onto rings. He needs every 10th here after coming off on pommel horse.
And he's a gymnast who's increased his strength. Well, you can see the power he's putting into those strength holds. Links it all very well indeed. Very stylish in his swinging. Lovely planche at the top. Controls the top of the handstand very nicely. Swings, forward swing up. Backward swing as well. He's really maximising this effort. Super dismount, tiny pace back, but the smile says it all. Good outing for Joe.
Well, what a great rings routine that is. And to maintain that strength and have that stamina all the way through with the strength-sapping start that he's got.
Well, you could see the absolute determination in Joe's face.
Zhang Boheng, 14.1 on rings. Joe Fraser, 13.6. Down on qualification. Drops to 18th. So this is how things look halfway around. Daiki Hashimoto, he's in the lead, stays there. Zhang Boheng moves up into second, and Brody Malone now in third. Tanigawa in fourth. Asha Hong sixth. Jake Jarman in 12th place. He's moved right up 10 places after vault. Great Great Britain's Joe Fraser dropping down to 18th after rings, but vaults to come for him now. Brace yourselves. Here comes Hashimoto on vault. It'll be big.
Well, can he control the nerves? Oh, he can! Triple twist in the Sugihara. Well, he's on song.
He's gonna be tough to beat. That's four pieces done, and just look at the way he delivered that vault.
Well, when we first saw him, we were very impressed with his competitive ability, weren't we? And that just shows you, you know, when you need the big landing, it's there.
And the big vault to go before it.
Well, absolutely. I mean, that will be the big D score and the big execution score.
So that's a 5-6. So that'll be marked out of 15.6. And that's all he's dropped, 0.1. 14.9 scored. Tanigawa was in fourth. He's got a good vault in him as well.
And he knows he's got to be just as precise. Oh, and how precise was that? That was a sixth start, double pike front with half turnout.
How did he land that?
And where did that come from? I mean, I thought Hashimoto's vault was impressive, but this, the Dragulescu in the pike position, I've rarely seen this vault before, and look at that landing. So this vault's out of 16. I mean, wow, that was just phenomenal.
I mean, he was straight down the line as well, and they'll credit him the pike as well. He was definitely piked.
It was that good, I'd give him 17.
Brodie Malone in third at the moment. Piece number 4 of 6 for him.
Well, an accomplished competitor when he hits. He does work this piece of apparatus so well. No hesitation there, straight into the handstand. That's what you're looking for. Lovely height there, the front somersault. Little pirouette on the end. Back down the bars, up into the handstand. Needs a big dismount. The double front somersault, just that slight hop back. It'll keep him in contention.
Oh yeah, there was some big difficulty in there and there was some beautiful execution, Chris.
There was, he's a very good parallel bar worker. And interesting to see these American lads have come out fighting today.
14.366 will do his medal challenge no harm at all. Well, let's look at this then. It's marked out of 16, Tanigawa's vault. It's the hardest vault that we've seen in this all-around final. It's a 15 score. 9 on the execution. Well, here comes another 6 difficulty. Asher Hong, just 18 years old. He's going to pull out something vault-wise that's absolutely incredibly difficult.
Powers down, turns on. Oh, it is incredibly difficult, and he just did not get quite enough rotation off the top. It's a double Sugihara with a full twist. It's got everything in.
Wow, this is a final. He blocks, full twist in, double back. He did so well not to get his hands down. I cannot believe the level of difficulty from such a young gymnast. He's so exciting, Matt.
Yeah. Goodness me, one to watch. And he hasn't long been in the senior ranks himself, but just look at the way he manages to rescue that. Asher Hong given a 14.166 for that sixth difficulty vault. Jan Bohang, you can see there, going for a 5-6 difficulty. So this one, all on execution. Hashimoto leading. Wataru Kamigawa in second. Brody Malone in third. Jan Bohang was in second after the last rotation.
Lots of focus. Oh, very nicely done. The handspring. Straight front with the 2.5 twist. A very clean vault.
Clean, and I was just thinking, he's cool as a cucumber, this guy, isn't he? I mean, you've just seen some massive, massive vaults, and to go down there and plant a triple twist, so good. That'll definitely keep him in the mix.
So what gap will there be between Boheng and Hashimoto after this vault score? But he's in second. Great Britain's Joe Fraser now next at the end of the vault runway. He didn't have a happy time on pommel horse, struggled a little on rings. Needs a big vault here.
Well, he's giving it everything. Oh, handspring double front. And just kicks out a little bit too early. He went for broke, he went for the big vault.
Yeah, what a shame, because absolutely powers down that runway. Blocks, you've got to block 2.5 somersaults from the hands. As you say, Christine, he doesn't hold back.
Joe Fraser awarded a 12.833. Carlos Yulo finds himself down in 13th, but he's got a big, big vault. He's the vault world champion, and he's qualified second for the final.
And my goodness, the power. Oh my goodness, double pike with the half turnout, and he just overcooked it. You don't see many gymnasts able to overcook a vault that difficult.
Huge rotation.
Well, he couldn't hold back, that's for certain. He'd see some massive vaults. Going to be tight to get onto the podium. There you see, he blocks. To me, he just didn't have the height of the previous gymnast. And actually, look, Christine, there, landed on a bit of a straight leg. So he's done well to walk away from that.
Carlos Yulo got himself up to seventh, but 14.166. Great Britain's Jake Jarman next on parallel bars.
Very smoothly up to handstand. Good, clean work. Oh, just a little extra step to bring it under control, but he did well. Whips the full turn. Very good handstand shape. And he flies along the apparatus high above the rails when he catches. And again, very nice and smooth out. Super double front with half turn. His huge spatial awareness for landings stands him in very good stead.
Brilliant, brilliant landing for Jake Jarman. He was in 12th, walking up to the parallel bars. Oh, we're hoping for a top 10 finish for Jake.
Yeah, great parallel bar work.
Oh, he's gone up into 6th, 14.166. So this is how things look then. After four, Hashimoto up, stays in the lead. Zhang Bohang into second. Wataru up into third. Jake Jarman is now in sixth. Nestor Abad stays in that 11th place. And Great Britain's Joe Fraser down in 19th. So rotation number five. Jim Nasir just warming up. That's your leader. Hashimoto leads this all-round competition. Max Whitlock in the studio, who's watching all of the action. Joe Fraser is just warming up on parallel bars, and certainly not the competition that Joe would have wanted, but he's muscling in there, Max.
Yeah, he is. I think, you know, there's a couple of falls. Obviously, he made a mistake on Pommel Horse, mistake on Vault, but you know what he's like. We saw in the team final that he can carry on pushing. There's still more to be done, if you was to predict it, Jake and Joe, they'll come into their own when we kind of get round to the last two rotations of the event. So we'll see how it pans out there.
Yeah, and Floor that we're watching now is one of Jake's fortes, and he's currently in sixth place. So he's had a good competition so far, Max.
Really, really good so far, like really clean, which is looking really, really strong. And like I said, like he'll come into his own, and like you said, with Floor being his strongest piece, last piece, that's actually a really good opportunity to try and bump up the leaderboard at the very last minute and kind of take it by surprise. He's like 1.6 away from bronze. It's going to be very difficult. It's a tough job because the other guys are strong on their last apparatus too. But as we know, it's not never impossible.
Brilliant, Max. Thanks a lot. We'll catch up with you shortly as we're just watching the reserve here, who's come into this final very late, Chris, but he's doing ever so well, is Christopher Mezerov.
He is, and we saw a fabulous first tumble. A bit more of a quiet tumble there, but he really has done a very impressive floor. I think this is probably his... No, I don't think his final tumble. We've got one more to come. He's efficient on his twisting. We've seen a great double front as well. And the ever popular triple twist to finish.
Well, he's making the most of his experience. Loving every moment, taking the opportunity. First few pieces.
Yeah, he'll have to swing this piece of apparatus well, and he has got a lovely rhythm so far. We talk about the extension over the pommel horse, drive the heel to create the momentum and the speed of the double leg circle. Great work, solid dismount. He'll be happy with that. He's putting together a great competition, Matt.
Yes. He's building. One more piece for him.
He looks like he's hobbling a little bit, actually.
Smiling through the pit. Mezeros came in as a reserve, 13.7. Take a photo of the scoreboard, it says first at the moment. Wataru Tanigawa, the gymnast, in third.
And so efficient on the parallel bars. Looks very at home in that handstand. Has to knock out there. Two good half turns. Very smooth in the travel along. Here it comes again. It's almost like high bar work, the way they've developed this parallel bard. And he's clean and strong, hits a lovely handstand. Oh, high front somersault. Caught easily and moved out of the situation well. Extends out, really nice extension forward into the dismount.
Absolutely superb stuff, and we could well be seeing two Japanese gymnasts on the podium.
Yeah, Christine, as you said, he was at ease on this piece of apparatus, and they do make it look like high bar work at time. The height they get above the rails, and so spatially aware there, the dismount, the double front, very popular.
Vanessa scores a 12.7 for Pommel Horse. Lucas Dowser now on floor. Scored 13.666 in qualification to a flying start.
Yeah, powers down the double front, the pike position. It's good control. The gymnasts link the skills together. That's where they build the difficulty and the bonus. Well, that was nice control there. Relatively simple straight back somersault. One and a half twist into the tuck front full. Strong finish. Not the most difficult routine, but he's through, he's clean.
Very nice technically. Really precise with his round off work.
.666 for Lucas Dowser on floor. Jake Jarman for Great Britain. He's in sixth place at the moment. His sights on high bar. He's just chalking up now. Well, Jake Jarman for Great Britain sealed the deal. The bronze team medal just the other day and Olympic qualification here on high bar. This one is all about him and his all-round final, the World Championships.
Well, that was a very nice start. You can see he changes the shape of his swing, kicks the heels back to Kachev's. You have to include a release and recatch, so he's done that nicely. You have to swing in different grips, and he's swinging there in an invert grip. And here's the work close to the bar, the close bar work. He did nice stalder, and another one. He's just got the dismount to go. Up he goes, just a single twist, but a near perfect landing. Well done, Jake.
Absolutely superb. Fifth piece of apparatus for Jake Jarman. There's just one more to go for him, and it's his favourite, floor.
Well, he's having a fantastic competition. This gymnast, I think, is about 18 months away from upping his difficulty. He's just going to be on song for the Olympic Games. Again, this is not his most difficult piece of apparatus, but I'm sure him and his coach are working away, adding a couple of big releases in there, and it's really going to change his all-round score.
Tanigawa scores 14.766 on parallel bars. He's still in the mix. Been piling the pressure on the top two, Zhang Bohang and Hashimoto. It's gymnast, the current all-around champion, hoping to retain his title, but it's not an easy job. Daiki Hashimoto is doing incredibly well. Hashimoto will be last up on parallel bars. Joe Fraser will be next after Zhang Bohang. Scored a 14.9 in qualification on this piece.
And without doubt, the best nation in the world on this piece of apparatus when they hit. And look at the control there. The turn from the one bar. Oh, that's fabulous work. The height there, the straddle front somersault, till pirouette and travel back down the bars. Changing the body shape. There, look at the flight there. The Babsar skill. Just a little bit of a pause there. That should go straight to handstand. No problem there, the full turn on the one arm, the heely turn. He needs a good solid dismount. Every 10. Oh, and just his chest down a little bit. You'll be feeling the pressure, Matt.
Yes, I'm sure he is. Actually, that just follows Asher Hong from the United States, who scored a 14.9. So he's moved up as well.
Yes. Parallel bars is the piece where... Parallel bars and vault are the piece where the scores really seem to rise. And Hong's worked very well.
Jake Jarman, 13.133. He's moved up to fourth
is
for
that,
now.
Like Rob the Buddha, the bald head.
Yeah. Here is Asher Hong's parallel bars.
Well, he's certainly a very exciting young gymnast. And he will have gained greatly from working in this top group with the best gymnasts in the world. That was a beautiful, smooth transition, a long, and he's able to swing right under these bars. Very good onto the one rail, smoothly out. Building the difficulty. Lovely full turn there. Very few empty moves. Here comes the dismount, double front with half turn.
It was absolutely packed from start to finish.
That was a great bit of parallel bar work. And a lasting impression for the judges, the dismount. Double front with half turn, plenty of height to spot the floor.
Asher Hong at 18 years old is up into second, 14.9. Zhang Bohang, 15.066. Huge.
Huge D score there, 6.4.
So the European and Commonwealth champion for this year and a previous parallel bar world champion. Joe Fraser qualified in seventh for the parallel bar final, so he'll have another go at this routine. And he scored 15.066 in qualification.
He'll want this for himself. Oh, come on, Joe. That's better. He's got a very difficult skill coming up, the long swing to one rail. There you go. Come on, come on. Oh, that's where he normally turns out. So he'll be down on his difficulty. Locks out in the handstand. Oh, he's going again. And he, oh, what a shame. He obviously knew he wouldn't have the start value, so he decided to put the skill in again to the one rail. That is so difficult.
And he really is not unsung this week at all, has he been?
No, but three majors in a year is a huge amount of effort. And he's had the biggest of years as well. And to be honest, the job was to qualify for the Olympics, and he's such a team player that that bronze medal that they won together will mean so much to Joe, and he's been absolutely superb. But really, this is not the way that he'd want to spend his parallel bars time. He's such a brilliant gymnast on this piece.
Well, hopefully get a day's rest before the parallel bar final. Solid dismount. But again, as we said, sometimes it's just not your day. But they've done the job, and they'll be back in the final on parallel bars on Sunday.
Gosh, he's been through so much. Ruptured appendix. He had a broken foot. Couldn't compete in the way he wanted to at the Commonwealths. He was brilliant at the European Games. Tang Chai Chung, Chinese Taipei, next to grace the floor.
Oh, beautifully done. Half in, half out. With the double back. Beautifully flighted series. Snaps his heels together, just like the textbook says. This gymnast has got the ability to make things look quite effortless. Super shape in that handstand. So really has been very clean indeed. Tremendous triple twist to finish. I wouldn't be surprised for him to end up in the top 10 again.
I agree, Christine, some fantastic work. Round on the triple twist.
Well, he's placed fourth with still quite a bit of gymnastics left to go in this rotation. And then there's the final piece to go. Well, Joe certainly won't want to see this score. 11.533. Carlos Yulo. In the parallel bars final, and he scored a 15.3 in qualification. Got a silver at the World Championships last year on this piece.
Another gymnast that hasn't just performed as well as he could, but that's a good solid start. Fantastic control. And again, turning out from the one bar. One of the most difficult routines. 6-3 on difficulty. lovely transition there, the front somersault into the handstand. One of the requirements to travel along and under the bars, he'll go back down again. Oh, lovely height there on the Bavzar skill. Spends much of his days training in Japan. Great so far. Needs a good dismount for a big score. Come on. Wow, double front with a half turn. That should go into the 15s. I like that, Matt.
Well, we've seen a few 15s. One from Jan Boheng, who's up there at the moment in the top two.
He was so precise with his handstand shape. He looked like he could hold those handstands for as long as he liked. And I think that's the best dismount I've seen. He was absolutely bolt upright by the time he finished.
Carasuza on high bar. It's reserved for the high bar final.
Oh, and that's why. Beautiful combination in the middle there. Oh, and the Kovacs, the back somersault over the bar in the straight position. Here are the Kachevs. We've got a very close-up angle here. You can see exactly the pressure on the hands. That was the squat dislocation into the Markalov, into the Gingasolto. So three difficult elements all linked. Wonder whether we'll flash out for the dismount. Yes. Oh. Controlled the pressure well of landing.
Well, it was high bar actually propelled the Brazilian team up in the team competition.
Yeah.
And you can see the pressure on all the joints when you land from such height.
Let's go, Brody!
Carasuza scores a 14.133 up into ninth.
Got it, come on. Yeah.
Gullov scores 15.166. It's huge. It's the highest P-bar score of the day.
Come on.
So on to the leader. Hashimoto is on a score of 57.765 at the moment. Two to go, parallel bars and high bar. So Hashimoto's penultimate piece of apparatus. He's hoping to add all-around world gold to his Olympic gold.
Confident start. Not a foregone conclusion. To really focus, that's good work. Nice straight arms, flight above the bars. Plenty of height there, the straddle front somersault. The pirouette, travel back down the bars. Good solid work, the Bavzar. To the centre. No hesitation there in the tipelt. Again, down to the dismount. Double front with the half turn. We've seen some good dismounts, Christine, but that's got to be with him.
Well, there's only 0.5 between Boheng and Hashimoto. Oh, one more piece to go. It's going to be big, and there's going to be a real fight on high bar.
Wow. He certainly controlled his nerves there. Look at the height in that front somersault. Beautiful technician. He is really a gymnast who makes everything look very easy, very smooth. The only thing there, he was a little bit low with his chest. But that was a great routine.
Well, Hashimoto scored a 14.733 in qualification. And Zhang Bohang has just posted a 15.066.
Yusha!
Okay! 15 scored! Wow, he needed that. Hashimoto stays in the lead.
It's very tight though.
This is a big high bar routine for Brodie Malone. Brodie was in fourth.
And this is his piece. This is where he's won his medals. Lovely straight full twisting Kovacs. And again in the tap position, caught at full stretch. Super height on the Kachevs. Three in a row. Maintains the great momentum. Oh, and that turn was right on top of the bar. And that. Very good high bar work here. That was just a little bit late on the half turn. The hop full. Come on, Brodie. Big dismount. And it is. He hasn't given anything away there.
Well, that was absolutely superb from Brodie Malone. He was under pressure with one to go, sitting in fourth place. What a landing under the circumstances.
And what a routine. I absolutely love the construction of this high bar routine. The variety between the Kovac skills and the Kachevs. Most gymnasts do a single Kachev, but it combines three in a row. I mean, just fantastic.
14.5. He's competing against the parallel bar scores on the other side of the arena. Floor will be last for him. Ilya Koptun of Ukraine, 13th.
Good opener, full twist, immediately punches into a double front somersault. Oh, just that little step out, he's such a powerful gymnast. It suits him on this piece of apparatus. Oh, the 3.5, this is big work. Two and a half, you can see he really does attack each tumble. Snaps his feet into the floor to generate the height. Control, 2.5 twist in the straight front. Nice flare work, just adds a little bit of originality to the routine. Powers for the final tumble, triple twist. Much better work, Koptun.
One more piece for him, and it'll be pommel horse.
That was the final tumble, the triple twist, but he included a 3.5 in that tumbling display.
Nesta Abad.
Oh, that was super, wasn't it? Full twisting front, immediate double front. Oh, and in the pike position as well. Oops, in the triple twist. The first day of competition saw quite a lot of the men struggling to control this floor. Every floor is a little bit different in its springs, but they've certainly got to grips with it now.
Oh,
Ooh, super landing of the double twist in front to finish with. Delight with that routine.
Nesta Abad, a 13.8.
Well, he's certainly pleased with that routine, Matt.
Yeah.
Great performance.
So this is how things look with one piece to go. Hashimoto hangs on in the lead ahead of Zhang Boheng, just 0.4 in it. Very close. Tanigawa in third. Asha Hong climbing in fourth. Jake Jarman is in eighth place alongside Ilya Kovtan. And then moving further down the field, Joe Fraser dropping down to 21st. Beth, not a place we're used to seeing Joe Fraser in the all-round competition.
No, I mean, obviously, he's not had the best of competitions, but he'll keep fighting through to the end. He's had a long week of competition already, and he's still got finals to look forward to. So he'll walk away from this competition with experience and obviously a smile on his face, to the point of he's got more finals to look forward to.
Yeah, I think at the end there, he was just trying to put on a bit of a show for the home crowd, really, wasn't he? The way that he applauded at the end. But that's the thing about Joe, he's always thinking of others.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen him perform so much better. And I think I heard Christine say in commentary, it's just not been his week. He's had mistakes here, there and everywhere. But sometimes it just goes like that. You can train and train and train, and he has had a very busy season. And not only that, I was discussing it with Max before, normally you come into a competition fully fit as an all-arounder, but he obviously did the Commonwealth Games when he only did the four apparatus because he wasn't fully fit from the foot injury. So not only was he having to come into a Europeans and a Worlds at full fitness, he was having to build that fitness, build that confidence to be able to do the all-around competition. So he will be disappointed, of course he will, with the performance, but he'll put it behind him, and he's still got a bronze medal in his pocket already, and he's got P-bar final to look forward to.
Absolutely. Max, I just want to grab your thoughts on the top two here, Hashimoto and Zhang Boheng. There's just 0.4 in it as they go up to high bar. Oh, it's going to be tense, this one.
It's going to come, We kind of predicted that it would be very, very close when you look at these and their previous history in the last Worlds, and you know how it's gone in terms of how it went in Tokyo. These two are, in terms of what they've done today, like the standard is extremely high. When you look at the step up from, you know, qualification, especially from Boheng, like in terms of what they're doing here, it's incredible, incredible gymnastics.
Yeah.
So it's exciting when it comes down to high bar, the last piece.
Yeah.
And it will be very, very, very close, I'm sure, because they're both mega, mega high bar workers as well.
And this young lad here, 18 years old, Asha Hong in fourth place. What a talent.
Huge talent and very young. And what's amazing about him is he's an all-rounder, but also he's got real specialist pieces. So very similar to Jake in a way. So those two gymnasts are very... Oh.
Well, he just played safe and brought it in a bit too close, didn't he? Didn't want to let himself fly away.
He warmed that up beautifully, actually. I was watching him over the top of the monitor. But,
when you catch as close as that and your elbows are bent, you just cannot hang on to the bar. The forces at the bottom of the swing just rip you off.
Well, I'm sure, as we were just saying with Max there, he's got a great future and he's going to be around for a lot longer. There's proof that he can do it, look.
Yes. Oh, wow, that was so high, the one without the somersault without the full twist. And here is Kachev series. Always impressed by a gymnast that will get back on and show, actually, I can do this. Very nice close bar work there. Stoop in and out. Big shape change. Double twist, double straight. Well, he's worked so well round. It wasn't until the final apparatus that he showed any sign of faltering.
That's it. Hardly put a foot wrong, but What a talent as an all-around gymnast, Craig. I mean, when you think of how varied these pieces of apparatus are, and at 18 years old, to have the difficulty level that he's got and the execution.
Yeah, absolutely. I think of all the gymnasts in this competition, I've been thoroughly impressed with his level of difficulty. And again, at just 18 years of age, certainly want to watch.
We'll join Lucas Dowser on Pommel Horse, traditionally for the Germans. It's been a tough piece as Pommels.
Well, he's starting strong. He's got one of these good lines in gymnastics. He's quite a tall gymnast and makes him look really good on the parallel bars, and he's swinging the pommel horse well. Just keeps the momentum moving of the circle. Just a little separation of the legs, but quickly glued the legs back together. He's through. He's put together a pretty decent competition.
Yes, he looks as though he could well be on for a top 10 finish.
I was just thinking that if he gets in the top 10, he'll be pleased with that for sure.
Yeah, he actually got ninth in the all-round at the Euros, so to be inside the top 10 at the Worlds would be phenomenal.
Well, he certainly worked with confidence.
13.2. Well, 11.5 for Asher Hong. That's his all-around competition done. And what an impressive performance it was. There's, I think, Yolo underneath his jacket. Well, what a high bar routine Zhang Boheng needs here. He's 0.4 behind the leader. And this then to retain his all-around title. The World Championships.
Well, that first element, the squat dislocation with full turn and then with half turn, were well on top of the bar, very clean. Into the straight, Kachev. Here's the shape change again. The full twisting, straight back. He's got a beautiful line in his work. And in the tuck position, smoothly through those two big releases. And whips through this. Circling, swinging work. Lovely stolder up to handstand. Here comes the dismount. Double twist, double straight. He's done his best. He hasn't really let any marks slip away.
He has. It's been a long way around the six pieces of apparatus. And it's now in the hands of Hashimoto.
Well, he qualified with the third highest score for the high bar final, so it definitely puts the pressure on Hashimoto, who's got a hugely difficult routine, and it's quite easy when you're going for broke to fall from this piece of apparatus. So he's certainly put the pressure on.
Jake Jarman with his last piece of apparatus. It's floor. He's an absolute master of this event.
Well, that's a huge opening tumble. Two somersaults in the straight position with three twists. And same going backwards in the tuck position. I mark this young man as a future world champion on this piece of apparatus. He's a phenomenal talent. Oh, and he's gone for broke. That was the element in qualification that he stumbled on. Triple twist down the side. Such an exciting performer on this piece of apparatus. And his challenge is to control his power. Into the 2.5 combined. Big final tumble. It's a 3.5 twist. Just what I said, he's got such a difficult routine. His problem is going to be able to harness all that adrenaline.
Well, it was the last move of all six pieces, an absolute strength sapper. And goodness me, has he impressed on the world stage. This is first all-around final. And the world is watching. Zhang Boheng scores a 14.433. He can do no more, a 6.2 difficulty. He's just got to wait now for Hashimoto to go. Joe Fraser finishing up on high bar. We just want him to get through this safely. He's put on a display of real heart here.
And so often being the anchor for the British team, that was a very nice half turn in me. Oh, it just wasn't to be. Ooh, and I hope he hasn't hurt himself, no. Well, when the team needed this big combination, he delivered. That was the big combination that gave the score to ensure that the team took the bronze medal. But it's a very, very risky, difficult element.
Well, take it easy, Joe.
Oh, he secures the straight Kovacs with full twist. Swinging very nicely. He's got a lovely rhythm and style on the high bar. Clean out there. Winds out for the dismount. Here it goes. Double twisting, double straight. Beautiful landing.
Well, he is something else, is Joe Fraser. He's going all out, as he always does to the finish. He's an inspiration for everybody who watches him, trains alongside him, and works with him. Jake Jarman, 14.433, sees him well inside the top 10 for his first all-around final. Tang Jae-kyung is in seventh, Chinese Taipei.
Oh, another gymnast. Right, yeah, people are making a top 10 finish. Separation of the legs there, but this is good work. It's the most difficult piece of apparatus, so he's just got to get through as cleanly as possible. No problem on the pirouette. Good competition. Well done, young man.
Celebrations all round.
Yes, beautiful, fluent work on the pommel horse.
For Tang Jae-kyung, finishes on 81.964. But Joe Fraser finishes with a 12.1. But what a huge effort from the man with the big heart. Carlos Yolo. He was the third highest qualifier coming into this all-round final. But sadly, his competition hasn't gone to plan. He's in sixth.
Lovely hop over the bar. Very nice squat dislocation with half turn. Here come the releases. Oh, and he brought that in close. He managed to hold on to the catch, but it interrupted his swing. He had to take a stop. Good hop full turn. And the 1.5. Very nice, smooth swinging. He's a beautifully extended gymnast in all his work. Kicks up high. Beautiful dismount with the double twist.
Wow, what a real shame for this gymnast. I really did want him to make the podium. Qualified in third spot. What could have been? We've had quite a few mistakes by the top gymnasts in this final. Quite completely different to the women's final last night. The women just seemed to pull it out of the bag and perform, all of them, fantastically. But we've had quite a few errors.
You rarely see a gymnast catch and in dead hang like that.
Ilya Kovtun, his last piece is pommels. Come on, Kovtun. Everybody here wants to see him have a good all-round competition. He's not going to be able to challenge for the bronze that he won in the all-round last time round, but finish on a flurry.
Yeah, and some good flare work there, the half turn, that's the spindle element. Oh, and that's very difficult skill between the handles. He is a very exciting gymnast to watch. Come on, keeps the momentum. Up into the handstand. Pirouettes, he's through! Well, what a fight, Ilya Kovtun.
Well done. And huge congratulations on, first of all, making the all-around final after all of the challenges that he's faced. Goodness me, he's training away from home, doing everything he can to do his country proud. And my word, are we pleased to see him here. Well, this is a huge high bar routine. Hashimoto hoping to add the world all-around title to his Olympic all-around title. And it's all on this routine.
Well, he doesn't hold back. It is full of jeopardy. Watch this. Full twist in Kovacs in the straight position. He's not done yet. In the tuck position. We're looking for full arm extension on the catch, and he does. He changes the tempo of the routine. A straight catch him, straddle catch him. Oh, a little bit late there. The squat dislocate with the full turn. He has a 6.7 difficulty, by far the most difficult. Come on, he kicks up. Is this for a world title? I think it is. Hashimoto for Japan.
It's got to be gold for Hashimoto. And what a way to round off his competition. Absolutely superb. He took the Olympics by storm with the all-around title. And here he is, surely on top of the world.
Well, great performance. He did play a little safe. He took out the big move that he fell on earlier in the week. So he probably won't quite have that big star value, but I think that'll be enough. He thinks it will as well.
Well, he needs over 14 for gold. Carlos Yolo scores 11.9 after the fall. Brody Malone with his last piece. He's in fifth. Big start.
Yeah, very big start, Matt. Lovely double front. really precise, using every centimetre of the floor area. Double, double. Enormously difficult, wide arm handstand. Precise into the corner. Double twist, forwards, immediate straight front. Down the side, the double twist. Just needs one more good landing. Very good in the triple. That might well put him on the podium.
Well, he was in fifth. Big score needed. Huge score needed.
I must admit, I've been really impressed with the American men tonight. We often see them falter in the latter stages of competitions, but they've been great.
14.133. He's gone behind Boheng.
Yeah, buddy. Nice job.
We're just waiting for Hashimoto's score to come in. Then there's Tanigawa to go.
Yes, sir!
It's enough. It's 14.433. He's gone ahead of Zhang Boheng. The competition is not over yet, but surely this man cannot be caught. Ushering the cameras away because his teammate Tanigawa is up next. And this from a bronze. Can Tanigawa get himself a medal here?
Well, he'll need to go all out. Oh, that was full stretch. Nice straight Katchev, straddle Katchev. Into the bar, Steinemann swing. Nice original work. Oh, great extension there, the squat dislocate. Oh, a little bit late with the half turn. Can he dismount himself onto the podium? Full twist in double straight, the hot back, we'll have to wait and see. Went for everything there, Christine.
Well, this is going to be very, very close indeed. Brodie Malone, Tanigawa, where's it going?
High bar is really a lower scoring piece generally, but he's worked very clean. However, Brodie Malone has worked very impressively as well.
Well, Tanigawa is the last gymnast to go on high bar. 13.3 is needed. That's for a medal.
And beautiful work. Look, he's folded. Such mobility in the shoulders. And in the pike fold, really very clean work. I think he'll do 13.3 if that's what's needed.
He had a 13.5 in qualification, but there were a couple of points in there, Chris. The full turn was a bit late, the hop on the dismount. It is going to be so close. Can Brodie Malone hang on to the bronze medal? And look at that, Jake Jarman currently in fourth position. What a competition he's had.
It's going to... I think it's going to be Brodie.
Do you?
I think I might have to agree with Matt.
No! It's in, it's 13.6 for Tanigawa. Well, it's Hashimoto, gold, Zhang Boheng, the silver, But what a story for Japan as Wataru Tanigawa takes the bronze. Brodie Malone pushed down into fourth, but Jake Jarman for Great Britain finishes in fifth place. But what a party for Japan. The last time they won the title was back in 2015. And Zhang Bohang has to hand his title over to Daiki Hashimoto.
And he confirms his dominance, really. Olympic champion, now world champion as well. He is that gymnast with that charisma.
Zhang Bohang, he takes the silver. Wataru Tanigawa, the bronze.
Well, on the men's side, it really has been Japan's championship so far.
So here is confirmation of the finals. Daiki Hashimoto, he takes the gold. Zhang Bohang, the silver, and Wataru Tanigawa, the bronze. Brodie Malone finishes fourth, but what a finish and what a final from Jake Jarman for Great Britain. He finishes fifth in the world in the all-round.
Oh, me, definitely.
I think Joe thinks it's him.
Joe.
But I'd probably say Gianni.
I'm going me.
I'm going to have to say myself just because, you know, I love my music.
Really? As if he said that? Wow.
Probably Jake.
I'm going for Jake.
I'm going to have to say Jake.
I feel like it's probably either me or Gianni, but I'm leaning towards Gianni.
I think we need a competition just to see who does.
James.
James.
I'm not very quick at these quick fires.
James Hall. I'd probably start warm up earliest, but maybe that's because I'm 27.
Courtney?
Courtney.
I'm probably the most likely to run late.
Joe.
Probably me.
Well, Joe was late yesterday.
No, you know what? I was saying me. Gianni.
I'm going to have to say Court.
I'm not going to go myself. G. Just because I don't want to seem like I'm choosing myself. Me.
Unintentionally, maybe G.
If between Jake and G.
Gianni.
He's a bit of a nutter.
We're usually laughing at him, just because I'm stupid.
Jake and Joe, thank you so much for joining us. Jake, firstly, you finished fifth. You've got to be happy with that.
Yeah, I'm a bit lost, to be honest. I've come into this comp just to have fun, to really just enjoy the experience. You know, for me, like, to be in an all-round final at World Champs is one thing, but to come fifth, like, I just can't believe it.
Craig on commentary said that by the Olympics you're going to be on song with the way that you're going. What do you think about that?
I mean, if I can, you know, get back into gym, work hard and really improve on a few things, then I'm hoping that I can.
Joe, it wasn't obviously the competition that you would have wanted. How are you reflecting on it?
You know, it's tough at the top. You know, we're working with angles and margins which are so minimal but can make such a difference in end result, whether you catch the bar or not. And, you know, today wasn't my day. You know, we're all pushing such high difficulty and trying to perform it perfectly, which is obviously so difficult. And it wasn't my day today, but you know, I'm so proud of Jake. He smashed it out there.
You've had such a big year, three major competitions. You've had issues with your appendix, a broken foot. Are you tired? Is it a case of just being quite fatigued?
I don't want to give excuses. I don't want to give excuses, but you know, I've struggled since the team comp mentally. You know, it's a big come down. you know, we're the third best team in the world, and then, you know, we've got to get straight back into competition, which is obviously difficult. And oh, like you say, it's been a tough year. But, you know, I'm still happy. I'm proud of myself, the team. Jake's gone out there and shown what a weapon he is.
Well, well done, guys. Thank you so much for speaking to us.
Thank you.
Just a word on that difficulty, actually, because, you know, it's very easy to sit and watch it, and these guys make it look so, so easy. But, Max, the way that the likes of Joe and Jake are just defying gravity.
100%. You know, it's great for Joe standing there saying he don't want to make excuses, but, like, it's easy for us to see it because from an outsider point of view, it's a tough year. Like, I feel comfortable in saying it, that to back him up, because it's a very tough year.
Yeah.
For an all-rounder, it's even harder because you're doing that multiple times in a year, three majors. It's the last one. It's the last final push. They've done amazing.
Yeah, and I'm not going to make excuses for them either, but the Japanese gymnasts didn't have a Commonwealth Games. But Hashimoto, you can't take anything away from him. Daiki Hashimoto, what a gymnast. We've loved watching him, you know, since he burst onto the scene really at the Olympics, and now he's got this to add to all-around.
His style is just so classy to watch, and he knows the decisions to make. He didn't necessarily go clean in qualification. He sorted those issues out, and he fell the other night as well. So today he did play it safe, but he'd worked that out with his coach. What do I need to ensure that I can pick up that title? He knew exactly what score. I mean, just to put his context, 6.7 is his highest bar difficulty. Yeah. Now, in the high bar final, that's nearly a mark above some of the other competitors. So he can reduce the difficulty and still be 5/10 ahead of people. So he's got that room to drop the difficulty and still be massively in front of the rest of the team, the field.
Yeah, and exciting because the specialists are coming out tomorrow. Joe, his job's still not finished. He's got B bars to do as well, but lots to look forward to the next coming days.
100%. We've got loads of finals across the men's and women's on both days. So, yeah, I think it's very exciting. I think what's exciting is that there's more potential medals. Yeah, there's gymnasts are starting to get tired, but it's almost that one or two last jobs for each of them, and I'm sure they'll push through. Even though they're making mistakes there with Joe, he can learn from them going in.
Well, that is it from all of us. Thanks for watching. Join us for more twists and turns from the finest gymnasts in the world, the specialists, tomorrow. From all of us here, bye-bye. Do it, do it, you do it, do it.